In this video, we're going to take a look at a real world type of scenario, which will help you kind of apply and combine all the things that you've learned in this module. So what we're looking at here is the Azure portal, specifically my Azure SQL database I've been using. And if I go down to advanced data security, we can see I've already accepted some of the recommended columns to classify. However, I go into here and I start to take a look at the possible classifications. And it looks like we have first name and last name classified as sensitive data or confidential for GDPR, but we don't have anything listed for middle name. So let's imagine a scenario where we decide that middle name is also confidential related to GDPR. So I can go ahead and create a new classification, and I'm just gonna find that customer and middle name. And I'm going to give it the same label as the other names. So we're going to call it confidential GDPR. So I can simply just add that classification, make sure to save, and very quickly I can see that it will come up in my classified columns here. Now, the next thing I might do is say, okay, well, we've realized this new column that contains sensitive information. We might want to go ahead and mask that column. You can see I've already added masks for first name and last name. So now I can simply just go ahead and select add mask and select that middle name column again. And I'm just going to use the default mask. And I'll go ahead and add and then save that. Now let's enter the SSMS and suppose that some people start querying this information. For example, right now I'm connected using Cloud Admin, so I can go ahead and just run this and I should have no problem, right? Because I am, you know, the master of all here, right? So I have access to all of this information. But now let's say we create a new user. Conveniently, his name is Bob and he loves the Titans, so there's his password. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and create him. And then we're going to execute a command as Bob. So you saw in an earlier video where I actually logged in as Bob Loves Tennessee, but in this case, I can just leverage a command you're probably all familiar with that is execute as user. And I'll execute as him until I use the revert statement. So I'm gonna go ahead and run the same thing. And even though he has read and write access, he hasn't been granted unmasked privileges to this data of first name, middle name, and last name. So you can kind of get a glimpse of what his view is. Now, let's say that for whatever reason, Bob becomes some sort of data officer and he needs to have access to actually see the information that's under here. Now, what I can do is as the admin, I can grant unmasked to Bob. And then if I run basically the same thing, executing as him, selecting that data, I'm going to be able to now see the first name, the middle name, and the last name all together. Now, let's say for whatever reason, or final scenario, that we want to revoke this privilege to Bob. Maybe, you know, Bob leaves the company or Bob does something bad and we no longer want him to have access. Whatever the reason is, we can take away that access using revoke unmask. And now we can run the same set of commands again. And sure enough, he is back to being masked on these sensitive data columns. Now, this might all be happening externally and you might be wondering, okay, who is trying to access this data? Maybe you've granted or revoked access to Bob and you wanna see if he's still trying to access this data. So one thing we can do is leverage the data that we have been collecting in with SQL Audit. And so what I'm going to do here is leverage the storage account that we set up for this. So what I can do is I can go to File, Open, Merge Audit Files, sorry. I'm going to go to Merge Audit Files and select Add. And I'm going to add these from Azure Blob Storage because that's where they're stored. So first I'm going to have to connect to my Azure account. So I'm going to go ahead and select the storage account, and then I'm going to select the SQLDB audit logs. I can select OK, and then I can even specify the server, which we're going to use this one, and the database, is that one, and then the time that I want to pull in those files. So I'm just going to pull in everything. I deployed this database earlier today, and it's going to tell me the number of files that are included in that. I'm going to go ahead and take them all. And you can see these are .xel files, and I'm going to hit OK. Now it's going to download and open all these files, and I increased the font size, so it kind of seems like a mess. But what I can do is now see various information about the client IP that people are connecting from, the statement that people are using, and other information about the queries. Now I'm just going to sort these based on timestamp. And we'll go the other way. And what we're seeing here in the statements is some of these comments that tell me we were revoking privilege or giving access to privilege. Now, if I go ahead and kind of dive into one of these statements, so let's do this one. This was execute as Bob. This is when Bob did not have access, and he's trying to access those sensitive comms that we've masked. Now, if I go into that, there's actually a data sensitivity information field. So I can double click in here and see, maybe we can zoom in on this, see that the sensitivity label was confidential GDPR and the information type was name and the rank was medium. So this is just one way how I might audit who's accessing our sensitive information. Now, another method I could take, since we also enabled log analytics for auditing for our Azure SQL database server, is I can switch over to the portal and go into View Audit Logs and select the dashboard. And so here I get a dashboard that's going to show me the access to sensitive data. So I'm going to be able to find out things like how many queries are accessing the sensitive data, what types of sensitivities are being accessed, and what principles and IPs. And what you can see is there are four queries that are there, and any of these items I can click into to learn more information about. So if I just scroll to the right and I look at principal access to classified data, what I'm seeing is there's four from Cloud Admin. Now, the reason Bob isn't showing up here is we didn't actually log in as Bob. We did an execute as Bob. But it's a good example to show how I can dive in. And here, now I'm seeing the logs behind that dashboard. And I can actually dive in and see the queries that were run here. So we can see that, yes, Bob was accessing the sensitive data. But because we execute as user, it's showing up as myself accessing that data. Now, another dashboard that's available is the Azure SQL Security Insights. And so I just thought I'd spend a minute showing you what that looks like. If I select that, I'm going to see a lot of different things. I'm going to see the audit distribution with some information, a distribution by database, so which database is being accessed, as well as the IP address. So you can see that private IP address that we've been using since we set up private endpoint, as well as the public IP address, and as well as the internal Azure that is accessing some of the telemetry. I can also see the SQL principles, who's accessing and actually logging in. So we do see Bob Loves Tennessee from an earlier exercise has showed up here. So this is just another way that you can kind of analyze and monitor the things that are happening in your database. So in this demo, you saw how to combine several different tactics like advanced data security, including data classification. We took a look at auditing from a storage account, and we took a look at auditing with log analytics and some of the dashboards that are included there. We hope you'll go through these exercises and see for yourself some of the capabilities in Azure SQL. See you next time.